How'd you get your chair?
Weird.
What is?
Well, for starters, we're practically in the 25th century and you're using a pen and a clipboard. On top of that, we've spent the past 40 minutes in silence, followed by you bombarding me with questions about B5. Followed by more silence. If you're going to be ship counselor, get to the relevant questions sooner.
As ship's counselor, I need to ensure that Starfleet Regulation 619 is
I am not emotionally compromised. I am merely celebrating the fact that the Flames have won a playoff series for the first time since the 2010s. Especially after that whole Connor McDavid transporter clone fiasco.
Care to explain all your time on the holodeck?
Am I not allowed to take care of myself emotionally, Tessler?
You spend 8 hours in there with the safety protocols off.
Orions are kinky. I like to live on the edge. Surely you should understand the concept of hard wood. What happened?
How'd you get your chair?
I asked first.
Actually, I did.
Okay. A Klingon friend of mine was very good at hunting tribbles.
Try again.
Okay. It was from my parents. It's been my family for...
Strike two.
Excuse me?
You mock everybody. You don't associate yourself with incompetence.
That's a pretty ballsy thing to say to the guy who's giving you a reason to be in Starfleet at all.
During the Kobayashi Maru, you allowed yourself to be taken prisoner to save the ship, and then you proceeded to annoy and blackmail the Romulan into releasing you.
Yeah, I'm definitely the last person you want in a prisoner exchange.
You also have no family members on your file. Actually, you have no family members, partners, friends.
Okay, I get it. So what if I implemented a clean slate policy after I was promoted?
Was this after White's death?
It was a gift.
Your chair?
No, your cane.
Yeah, it was.
And also the chair.
If it wasn't your partners or your friends...
Wife.
You're married.
Was.
What happened?
Doesn't matter, she's dead. Your cane is in standard issue. No one uses wood anymore. If it wasn't a gift, then I...
Captain! What happened?
Never marry a Section 31 doctor. They're great in bed, but as soon as there's a fight, there's all kinds of tricks. You trust someone once, and then next thing you know, they've microdosed you with the toxin of a Centaurian slug to try and manipulate your behavior. Fun thing is, even once you realize you've been poisoned, the photophobia is chronic.
And I thought the glasses were for show.
Thank you. I'll take that as a compliment. Most people think I'm Terran.
Why not just get your eyes fixed?
Why not you just get your leg fixed? Identities and physical scars can be erased easily nowadays. Memories. You're stuck with them.
So you keep your glasses and your chair to remind you not to get close to people.
And you don't? Seriously, prosthetics and surgeries have come a long way.
It's normal for people to feel defined by their illness.
So you did something brave. Something you're proud of. You sacrificed yourself for something. What was it?
We were part of a second contact mission. I was giving counseling to those who were having trouble coping with the fact that they weren't alone. Our science ship was old and underpowered, so when they tried to beam me up, there was a malfunction. I was able to use my comm badge to disable the sequence. I saved my superiors at the cost of the structural integrity of my leg.
I'm sorry. But that's not what happened. You're not the only one who likes to read files. I did my homework. You have survivor's guilt. You're the only one who survived that transport.
You knew.
Of course I knew. I just wanted to see how good you lie.
What happened to your wife?
Time.
Thank you for telling me the truth, Chris.
Who said I was telling the truth? Tessler.